In this video presentation, we're going to create a wall graphic in Job Editor. The requirements for this job are going to dictate that we crop the image and then enlarge that crop size to fill a door. We're also going to be applying tiling to this job. So let's begin with these steps. I'm going to start by setting my contour cutter and activating for my GraphTech cutter model. The reason I'm doing this is I am going to eventually set up a tile dotted overlap and generate my tile outlines as cut paths, so I want to ensure that I have my cutter model selected. Next, I'm going to crop the portion of the image that I need to represent. I'm going to go to preview and size, and in my crop size, I'm just going to start out with a basic dimension in here to give me a starting field. I'll put my cursor inside that box and I'll move it to the subject matter where I have to crop. So it's these three little rock areas here. I'm just going to adjust this crop so that I get just that image area. Now that I've set my crop, I'm going to apply. And now I can clearly see the cropped image. So this particular cropped area must sufficiently cover a door that's 54 inches wide. So my next step now is I want to set my magnification and enlarge the file. Before I do that, I need to enable tiling. So I'm going to go to my Tiling Setup tab, enable my tiling, and then go back to Preview and Size and set my image size to the 54 inches. If I did not set my tiling enabled first, once I set my size, it would exceed my roll size. So I need to accommodate that appropriately. So I'm going to set in there my 54 inches for my width. Because I had enabled tiling, I can now see the line where my tile panel will be. I can further edit that by going to the Tiling Setup tab, and if I wanted to split the difference exactly from the 54 inches so that these two tile panels were equal size, I would just type that in manually for my custom tile width. I'm going to set half of my 54 inch width. And now we can see I have even tile panels based on my dimensions. I'm going to set a 1-inch tile overlap. That's going to set a 1-inch left and right side splitting the difference so that my image area will be allowed to line up and I could use this visually as an overlap area. I'm also going to turn on my tile dotted overlap marks, although I don't need the top or the bottom or the right, I just want to set this for the left panel. In this way, I'll have one mating edge per adjoined tiles, and I'm only going to see that mark on one panel of the side. This is going to help us so that we don't see the marks showing on the installed print. Another mark setting I may want to enable is my generate tile outlines for my cut paths. So what I'm going to do is go to my finishing tab, and in the Marks tab, we're going to notice Generate Tile Outline Cut Paths. I'm going to turn on that feature. And what's going to happen is you're going to notice a magenta outline to the file. This is going to take any remaining amount of media is going to be applied as a cut path, and any extra bits of material would be cut away from my original roll size. So that's a very handy little feature in this case. Now I've set all my conditions, I'm going to submit this file to the RIP. In my print preview panel on the far right side, I can clearly see my two evenly spaced tile panels. Now I will print these files. Upon printing this file, my cut information has been sent to Cut Server. So I'm going to launch Cut Server software. You'll notice that application in the top part. We can select Cut Server to launch. And now for our GraphTech cutter model, we see the cut information. I'm going to select that and we can clearly see that tile outline generated as a cut path. At this point, I would take my print, go to my cutter, ensure my lineup control points, And then at the very bottom, I would select cut now and send this cut information to the plotter to cut that little extra trim area around the tile outline. Our final output result will be an installable wall art job that is utilizing the cutter to do the tiling trimming.